Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Impressive Channel. Beyonce just dropped her latest album called The Gift, and it is a soundtrack for the live action version of The Lion King that she stars in. And I just have to rave about this album because it's just hitting all of the African emotions in me right now. I'm just so proud of Beyonce and how she is using her platform to uplift and empower Black people. The album is incredible, and it's beautiful, it's powerful, it's bold, it's soulful, it's thought-provoking, it's energetic and full of life. It's something that I thought I never needed until now. I thought Beyonce did a great job putting this album together, and she did not have to make a whole soundtrack, but you know what? I think it was necessary, not only for the promotion of The Lion King, but it was necessary for Beyonce, and it was necessary for her fans to hear. I want to first talk about her song, Bigger. I do like the song, Bigger. I feel like it was a ballad dedicated to her children. And I like the fact that it talked about the importance of legacy and self-awareness. You know, knowing who you are. You're bigger. You're not insignificant in this world, despite the lies that people may have told you. So I really do like that message. And I also liked her vocals on this song as well. I thought her vocals exploded in the second half of the song. So I do like this song. It's not my favorite, but I do like it. The next song on the album is called Find Your Way Back, and this song right here is a whole vibe. It's like a mix between Afrobeat and house music. I think that's the best way I could explain it, but I do like this song. It's a soothing up-tempo record, and it is catchy as well. You'll find yourself kind of humming this song after you listen to it. The next song on the album is called Don't Jealous Me, and it's featuring three popular Nigerian artists: Tekno, who I absolutely love. Tekno is one of my faves. Also, Yemi Alade, Looking for My Johnny. Love that song. Anyway, that's one of her songs. And it also features Mr. Easy. This song right here had me moving, okay? When I put this song on, I couldn't help myself. I started dancing and twerking. That's what this song makes you want to do. I have to admit, this is one of my favorite songs on the album simply because it's infectious and it makes you want to dance. Like, I don't know what's in it, but it just makes you want to dance. The next song on the album is called Jaara E, featuring another Nigerian artist, Burna Boy. I love the jazziness in this song. It's so saucy. It's so sensual. It's so, I just love it. I love it. This is also another one of my favorite songs on the album. Next song I want to talk about is Nile, featuring Kendrick Lamar. And I have to say this, Beyonce and Kendrick tried it, okay? They tried it. This song was too short. Now, they know better than to put out a half song like that, and they cut it off right when it started to pick up. They know better than that. They need to go back and give us a real song. But if you're into the whole spoken word vibe, you might like this song. Me personally, it wasn't my favorite. The next song on the album is called Mood Forever, featuring Jay-Z and Childish Gambino. And the song is an up-tempo celebratory track. And also, Jay-Z and Beyonce were flexing hard in this song. Beyonce, she kind of shocked me a little bit when she said this, and I quote, "I'm so unbothered. I'm so unbothered. Y'all be so pressed while I'm raising daughters. Sons of empires, y'all make me chuckle. Stay in your struggle. Crystal blue water, pina colada in, you stand Ramada in. Ooh, my baby father, bloodline Rwanda. Why would you try me? Why would you bother? I am Beyonce Gazelle Knowles Carter." She sure did snap, didn't she? The next song on the album is an up-tempo tune called Water, featuring Pharrell and another artist from the Cameroon named Salatiel. I don't know if I'm saying that right, but he was on the song, and I do like the fact that Beyonce featured several African artists on this album. The next song is hands down my favorite song on the album, and it's called Brown Skin Girl, featuring St. John, Wizkid, and Beyonce's daughter, Blue Ivy Carter. First of all, I love the production in this song. It is simplistic and it does have these simple piano chords, but it has a slow winding sound that comes to a break and then starts up again. And it has those brilliant traditional African drums in the background. I just really love the sound of this song, and I love how the melody complemented the beat. And what I love the most about this song is the message. I thought it was amazing that Beyoncé used her platform to uplift brown-skinned girls, because women with darker skin have often been underappreciated, underrepresented, and also frowned upon when it comes to the beauty standards in society. And I'm glad that Beyoncé was not afraid to address this in her music, because she's talking about Black pride. And a part of Black pride is embracing your melanin, embracing your rich, deep skin tone. And I really do like that. You know, she was saying, brown skin girl, skin like pearls, the best thing in the world. I'll never trade you for nobody else. In her second verse, I love this line that she said, melanin too dark to throw her shade. I was like, yes, period. So there's no point in throwing shade at dark skin girls, because dark skin, brown skin girls are fly, okay? So don't waste your breath, don't waste your time. And I liked her last verse in the song. It said, oh, have you looked in the mirror lately? Wish you could trade eyes with me, because there's complexities in complexion, but your skin, it glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be given birth. Took everything in life, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taken over. Most things out of focus, view. But when you're in the room, they notice you, cause you're beautiful. Yeah, you're beautiful. And also the next verse, them men gonna fall in love with you in all your glory. Your skin is not only dark, it shines and it tells your story. Keep dancing. They can't control you. They watch it. They all adore you. If you ever are in doubt, remember what mama told you. And Beyoncé's daughter, Blue Ivy, came in and started singing. And I love that. That was so adorable. So she's not only affirming other brown-skinned girls, but she's also affirming her daughter as well. And she's telling brown-skinned girls to know your beauty, know your worth, and be proud of your skin. Because brown skin is popping, and I'm talking about all shades of brown skin, from light to medium to dark. It is all amazing, and deep dark skin is something special. It really is. The next song on the album is another mid-tempo Afrobeat song called Keys to the Kingdom, featuring another Nigerian artist, Tiwa Savage, and also Mr. Easy again. And I do like the song as well. It's very uplifting, and it kind of falls in line with the storyline of The Lion King, where Simba had to grow from his past and face his future and realize that he's the key to the kingdom. So I like that message, and I do like how the song stayed on theme with the movie. Okay, so the next song on the album was called Already, and I do like the song a lot. I especially love the chorus. It's very catchy. And Beyoncé featured a group called Major Lazer, and she featured another African artist by the name of Shatta Wale, and he's from the country Ghana. So once again, Beyoncé is giving African artists shine, and I really do like that. The next selection on the album was called Other Side, and this song is a very beautiful, soothing ballad. The instrumentation was beautiful. The harps were a big part of the sound of the song. And I like the fact that Beyoncé was singing in Swahili towards the end of the song. And her lower register is just so rich and deep. Like, I was in awe. The way that she's able to interpret a song vocally really shows her musicality. She knows how to use her voice like an instrument. So the next song on the album is called My Power, and I like this song a lot as well. This is also one of my favorites. It's a very aggressive Afrobeat song. The mood of it is almost like you're going to war. And the song My Power featured three artists, one of them being Tierra Whack, who is a rapper, and I'm glad that Beyoncé had Tierra Whack on her album. That is huge for Tierra. Also, the song featured an artist named Nija and an artist named Moonchild Sanelli, who is from South Africa. And I really loved everybody's contribution to this song. I just love it, and I think it would work well for that fight scene between Simba and Scar in The Lion King. I really do. The next song on the album was called Scar, and it featured the artist Jesse Reyes. And the song was very dark and woeful, and it reflected the mood of Scar. Last but certainly not least, the album ended with the song Spirit. And this was a single that Beyoncé recently released, and she also filmed a beautiful music video for it. And I do think the song is powerful, it's triumphant, it's elevating, and it's also spiritual. In a part of the song, she was talking about how the spirit will be joined with the great I am. So in a way, it's talking about transitioning from life on earth to life in heaven. And I also love the choir in the background. And Beyoncé, of course, showcased her amazing vocals. This album overall was a great album. Beyoncé really immersed herself in the African culture and made sure to deliver an album with authentic African sounds that include current Afrobeat music and traditional African music. I really enjoyed this album, and I do believe that it is Oscar worthy. Anyway, tell me what you all think about this video down below, and also tell me what your favorite song on the album is. Anyway, please like, comment, and subscribe, and share this video if you care. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.